Hi everyone and welcome back. So now we started using use formic hook, and in this code now we are going to add validations. So use formic hook takes validate as an argument. So here we can pass validate, and validate can be a simple function. Okay, that function we can create const validate here in the outside. Here we are not reusing yep for now. So const validate. This can be a simple arrow function which is accepting the values, and we are validating these values as an argument. Okay, now what we can do is the simple error validation which we were doing earlier. We will create a const error object and values.firstname. Here we have two arguments, email and password. So we will just say values.email and set error with email. Values dot email and then emails, like if you want to set some length of email 5 characters, and then set this with the email. Similarly, you can do same thing with the password. We have only two fields for now, values dot password. Then we are setting this for password, it is required, and password length also should be greater than 5. Must be 5 character, or this would be 5 character. Okay, simple validation, and we are passing it here, validate function. So this will be applied to our HTML form. Now how should we show the messages? We will use the same technique. What we need to do is we need to just check formic dot errors dot, you can say name, because name is the parameter, sorry, email is the parameter we have. If this is true, then we just can just print the value, whatever we are getting from formic dot errors dot email. Otherwise, what we can do is just show the empty message, formic dot errors dot email. Why it is complaining? Okay, this is how we can print the error for this email, and same thing we can do for the password, formic.errors.password. If value is there, then show it, otherwise show it as empty. Okay, then you can do few more things, like you can just check the touched property for each and every formic component. If the field is touched, then only show this, right? This is the extension we can do. So what we can do is we can just add a or condition, formic.touched.email. This is how we used to do it. So if both conditions are true, then only show this message. If the field is not even touched, then we will not show the error message, this condition. So similarly, we can add this for the password. formic.touched.password. If you have entered into that field, if you have interacted with that field and still the field is holding incorrect value, then show the error for the password. Okay, these are basic form validation which we are doing without using yup module, because this is the validate function we are passing. With the yup, you will be just creating a schema, validate schema, and we will be passing validate schema here. So this is kind of same we have used in the formic component. It's just a hook which is giving you the extra advantage to write these forms with the simple functional component. Okay, and we can get the advantage. So here all the other attributes you can access. So if you just see what all we have, reset, warning, cache and all. And from these values you can access all the parameters, values, errors, everything is available on the onSubmit method. Okay, here we also have formic helpers. If you wanted to do a manipulation in the array, like if you are using a field array, currently we are using the simple HTML form. And when you are using some simple HTML form, always add no validate. Otherwise, the HTML5 also will start adding the form validation. Now, you can actually convert this into a formic form using this formic form tag, and you can use a field attribute here. Okay, that we will do in the coming videos. Thanks everyone.